community. The prayer team will be available in the chapel after Mass today to pray with you for any intentions or concerns you have. Come and experience the power of prayer. God has gathered us together to renew our efforts in sharing the life of Christ and being the love of Christ. So let us stand, introduce yourself to those you do not know, and greet the presence of Christ in one another. Our gathering song is number 418, All Are Welcome, number 418.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Good evening, everyone. As we gather on this 4th of July weekend, we gather to celebrate our nation's independence. We also gather to celebrate our interdependence upon God for life, for love, for forgiveness, and grace. So we turn to the Lord, who is our help, who is our true source of freedom. And we come and we offer to him our need for forgiveness by acknowledging our sins, by welcoming his presence and grace today. Lord Jesus, you are forgiveness for the sinner. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you are food for the hungry. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are healing for the sick. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore.
Let us pray. O God, who in the love of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, rejoice with Jerusalem and be glad because of her, all you who love her. Exalt, exalt with her, all you who were mourning over her. Oh, that you may suck fully of the milk of her comfort, that you may nurse with delight at her abundant breasts. For thus says the Lord, lo, I will spread prosperity over Jerusalem like a river, and the wealth of the nations like an overflowing torrent. As nurslings, you shall be carried in her arms and fondled in her lap. As a mother comforts her child, so will I comfort you. In Jerusalem, you shall find your comfort. When you see this, your heart shall rejoice, and your bodies flourish like the grass. The Lord's power shall be known to his servants. The word of the Lord.
God's name, proclaiming forever, tremendous your deeds for us. Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord, leading your people safe through fire and water, bringing their souls to life. We sing of your glory, your love is eternal. Unto love, let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord. Let all the earth cry out in joy to the Lord, to the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, may I never boast except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, through which the world has been crucified to me and I to the world. For neither does circumcision mean anything, nor does uncircumcision, but only a new creation. Peace and mercy be to all who follow this rule and to the Israel of God. From now on, let no one make troubles for me, for I bear the marks of Jesus on my body. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with your spirit, brothers and sisters. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Our reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. At that time, the Lord appointed 72 others, whom he sent ahead of him in pairs to every town and place he intended to visit. He said to them, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest. Go on your way. Behold, I am sending you like lambs among wolves. Carry no money bag, no sack, no sandals, and greet no one along the way. Into whatever house you enter, first say, 'Peace to this household.' If a peaceful person lives there, your peace will rest on them. But if not, it will return to you. Stay in the same house and eat and drink what is offered to you, for the laborer deserves their payment. Do not move about from one house to another. Whatever town you enter and they welcome you, eat what is set before you, cure the sick in it, and say to them, 'The kingdom of God is at hand for you.' Whatever town you enter and they do not receive you, go out into the streets and say, 'The dust of your town that clings to our feet, even that we shake off against you.' Yet know this, the kingdom of God is at hand. I tell you, it will be more tolerable for Sodom on that day than for that town." The 72 returned rejoicing and said, "Lord, even the demons are subject to us because of your name." Jesus said, "I have observed Satan fall like lightning from the sky. Behold, I have given you the power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and upon the full force of the enemy, and nothing will harm you. Nevertheless, do not rejoice because the spirits are subject to you, but rejoice because your names are written in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The 72 returned rejoicing. Amazing, isn't it? Amazing that the 72 could come back rejoicing. After all, as Luke tells us, their job was no simple task. They were to go, to be on their way, to know that they were lambs amongst wolves. Well, if that doesn't send chills down your spine, nothing does. And after Jesus tells them they're going to be lambs amongst wolves, then he tells them, take nothing on the journey. No bag, no sandals, no money, nothing. Except the shoes on your feet and the shirt on your back. And then he tells them, say peace to this house. Sometimes that peace will welcome you, sometimes it won't. But wherever you go, eat what's set before you. Don't complain. Simply do your task. And the message is brief. Keep it brief. The kingdom of God is at hand for you. What a simple homily, huh? They didn't even have to memorize it. But it's amazing, in the midst of all of that stuff, of not having anything for the journey, being totally dependent upon somebody else for hospitality and food, and of course, being lambs in the midst of the wolves, Luke tells us the 72, why they came back to Jesus rejoicing. They were filled with joy. So where did the joy come from? Was it because demons were subject to their name and that they had these great powers, and that they were indeed, because of what power Jesus had given them, they were able to heal the sick and expel demons? Yes, I'm sure that was part of their joy. Was the joy because, of course, people were nice along the way and the food was pretty good in the houses they entered? Perhaps. It's the joy, the result, of course, of the fact that, well, the fact that they had gotten there and gotten back safely? Certainly. But perhaps, my guess is that their joy came from a discovery. And the discovery comes from a saying, and I apologize to you because I don't remember where I read it or who wrote it, but the saying goes like this. I went to sleep and I dreamt that life was joy. And I awoke and saw that life was service. And so I acted and discovered that service was and is joy. Let me repeat that. I went to sleep and dreamt that life was joy. I awoke and saw that life was service. I acted and discovered then that service was and is joy. It's what the 72 discovered on the way. It's what the 72 were able to encounter on the journey. Because it wasn't what they took with them that mattered. It wasn't who received them necessarily that mattered. It wasn't even the fact that they were sent out two by two, although that was important. It wasn't even as though that was of the greatest importance. What was important was that those 72 sent out in pairs began to discover that when they were able to bring this message that was for you and for me, why, then they began to discover that in giving the message, in healing the sick, in caring for those that were entrusted to them, that came along their journey, why, it was in that service that they extended to them that they discovered that it was in service that they found their joy. It was in their service that they found their joy. On Monday, we, as a nation, celebrate our 240th birthday. 240 years ago, our ancestors, why, they came together and they too had a dream. They dreamt that life was joy. And so because of it, they ventured out and they acted. And of course, they put together this document, this Declaration of Independence, and in it, of course, they discovered and they stated the need for life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, the pursuit of joy for everyone. And that joy, that happiness, that life, that liberty that you and I enjoy each and every day of our life by virtue of being citizens of this country comes, of course, as we know, with a price. And the price is service. And service is not a bad thing, my friends. It is where we will discover true joy. It's where the 72 discovered it. It's where we discovered along our own life's journey. So as we gather here to be fed along the way, as we come to encounter Jesus who gives us the strength in this Eucharist to go out in pairs, two by two, to bring a simple message. It's brief, my friends, and we should never forget it. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. It is at hand for you and for me. And in bringing that message of hope, in bringing that message of life, in bringing that message of liberty, why then, my friends, all of us can experience true happiness, which is joy itself, discovered in our service, in our love for one another, and for our neighbor. And the 72 came back rejoicing because of all that they had done, and the lives that they have touched. But they also came back rejoicing because Jesus bent down and he whispered into their ear, as he does into your ear and mine. And he says to you and I, servants of the Lord, rejoice, because your name is written in heaven. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us, and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Gathered here in prayer, let us acknowledge God's presence and our need for help by offering these petitions.
That the church be blessed with strong leaders and courageous disciples of Jesus Christ, who are eager to share his joy, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our country be thankful for the blessings we have, especially our many freedoms, and be eager to share our abundance with those who are less fortunate, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we seek to follow the simple life Jesus taught, rather than becoming too caught up in the controversies of our time, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That farmers and gardeners be blessed with good weather and a bountiful harvest to help feed the hungry, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick be healed, and those who have died, Vernon, Yvonne, and Scott Koffenberg, have a share in the fullness of heaven, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in celebrating our nation's independence this weekend, all travelers on our roads and lakes will be kept safe. Family gatherings will be life-giving, and those in the military will be thanked for their service and sacrifice. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of glory, Lord of life, you indeed are the giver of every good gift. And so we acknowledge the gift of your presence, the gift of your Son that is ours in this Eucharist. As you send us forth, may we bring your message of hope, of life, and of liberty to the waiting world. Hear us as we pray, answer our petitions according to your will, for we ask them through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our song for the preparation of gifts is number 428, Amazing Grace, number 428. Thank you.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this offering dedicated to your name purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, with all the clergy and with all your people. Remember also our sisters and our brothers who have died in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Together we now pray for the coming of God's kingdom as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share with one another a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those now called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song is number 328, Taste and See. Number 328.
Taste and see the good.
my soul shall glory in the Lord. For he has been so good to me. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Oh, taste.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
There will be a Mass on Monday, the 4th of July, here at the Church of St. Mary. That Mass will be held at 9 a.m. here at the church. Wishing all of you a very relaxed and safe 4th of July holiday weekend. And, of course, enjoy this beautiful weather. Our Mass is now ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Our sending forth song is number 632, America the Beautiful, number 632.